All right, here we go. One H-copter, version 4, maiden attempt. It is still very windy outside, but I need to get this thing in the air so I can see where the setup of it is. I'll move it into the light a little bit. I'll have the camera on for a bit of onboard footage. I'm just going to put it up in the garden because I can't be bothered to drive anywhere where it's an open space, because if that windy, it's not worth my time and effort. Problem is, the battery is not the best fixing in the world, which I thought, so I won't be able to throw it around that much. I'm just going to go for a balanced kind of gain setup. If I can, I've got the gains for pitch and roll set up on these controller knobs on my handset. Thing is, the jumping quite big jumps. It's like two bigger jumps. I'd rather it went up in 5 and 10, 15, but it goes up in percentages of something like 20, 30, 50. The more you twist it to the right, the bigger the jump seems to go. So I'm hoping I think the gains are quite close anyway, based on the last one of these I built. So I'm hoping I'm going to be there and I won't need to twist that pot too much. FPV gear is plugged in, excluding the camera, which I need to work on, so it depends how this test goes. Again, the props, I'm going to see how this goes. If I can use the 10 inch props, if it seals okay, then yeah, I'll probably go with this initially, but ultimately we'll end up with 9 inch props on. And again, I'll probably have to play around with the gain setup, but again, that should be close by then. That's about it. Let's go shove it in the air. It's got this camera. I'll put that one on as a test, but it won't get much feedback because I don't want to put it too high up because the neighbours are in and they always scream, "What's that?" as all these things pop up over the fence. So we'll see how it goes. It feels heavy. The battery, yeah, too heavy, but we'll go for it. I think it's got a good CG. Really test the battery, could go, yeah, it's not bad. I'll go with that. So let's go and let's go shove it in the air. Oh, I need to do a bit of a GPS calibration as well, because I haven't used this for a while, so I'll do a quick one of those once it's got its satellites.
Thank you.
That concludes the test, or quick test, I should say, of my version 4.1 H-copter. 3D printed, homemade everything pretty much on it. It flew okay. It wasn't great. It wasn't bad. It's somewhere in between, I guess. A few quirky things on it. It just felt heavy. It felt really heavy in the air. It took a fair amount of throttle to get it off the ground. At one point, I didn't think it was going to lift off. And then the motors didn't seem to spin up on it initially until I got to half throttle. And then it seemed to jump in the air. It all seemed a bit weird. It does have a firmware version upgrade, which I just did on this, on the NASA. So maybe there's something different in the NASA there. I haven't never read up on it. I just kind of test it and see what happens. So yeah, there was something a little bit quirky there, the way the motors started, which I had noticed when I was trying to do a few basic settings on this with the props off, but props on and in flight mode, it was something certainly quirky there. I haven't used the Sunny Skies motors before. They seemed okay. They seemed underpowered, I would say, but that's hard to tell at the moment because everything just felt so heavy. And perhaps I've been flying other multicopters which feel a lot lighter. This feels more like a bit of a old donkey in the air. So I need to tweak the gains on the NASA. They were slightly high, if anything. Not far off, I've got to say. I'd happily fly it in that condition with the gains that are currently at. 110 for pitch, 110 for roll. They were based on a previous version of this H-copter, which is slightly larger. So if I come down on the gains, 10, maybe even 5, could get away with a very slight oscillation. The blustery wind hasn't helped. It was hard to diagnose what was going on. At some point, I was getting under the props, and it was just getting a bit of a shake going on. It could not find a GPS lock on it at all, so it was hard to tell whether the GPS hold was working or not. I don't think it was. It seemed to be dialing in and out of the satellites found, and it is a bit of a cloudy day, and it's been overcast and pretty stormy lately, so I don't think that's helping its satellite lock. It's been a while since I have used this one, so I know from other GPS units, once it's found the location in the world it's at, it seems to find them faster and faster each time you use it, but it hasn't been used for a long time, so maybe it's a little bit messed up on that. What else? I'll have a look at the footage. That should be okay. It'll be hard to tell, really. I should turn that off. It's heating up. Yeah, that should take out a lot of the vibrations, but it was rocking and rolling a little bit, so I think that'll give a bit of motion sickness, but it should give me a good idea as to whether I've taken the vibrations out using that or not. Is too heavy, which I sort of knew anyway. I'm pretty sure I've got a 4-cell 4000 milliamp battery somewhere. I'll have to go rooting around for it because that'd be nice to get a 4000 on there. This 5, it just seemed too heavy. Weird as it was. I think I've used 3 cells on this before, so maybe that's why it's feeling a little bit heavier with a 4-cell on there. That's possibly why. I'll do a weight check, but it just seems weird that it felt so heavy this time around. Apart from that, I'm sort of happy with it. I need to change the gains a little bit. I'll leave these props on for now, but if I get a chance to fly it properly out in the field somewhere, then as a quick test, I will probably put some groupers on there. I'll see. I might do a back-to-back test. I might test it with these on and then swap over to the groupers. See how it goes. Rest of it seemed okay. Seems solid enough and smooth enough considering that was the first time in the air, so I'm sort of happy with that. And flies okay. If you want a donkey, That's the one you want. If you want something that's a bit of a racing snake, then this is not what you want at all. I'm kind of horrified at how lardy it felt in the air. So, I don't know. We'll see how it goes. And I used to like this one. It used to be good fun, but maybe flying all the other different ones, this one is past its sell-by date. I'm not sure. I'll fly it until I crash it, I guess. I'm not sure I'll make another one or not. I think there's better ones to be made. And lighter ones. So watch this space. I'll definitely give this a go, and I'll definitely get the FPV camera on and give it a justified flight. Find somewhere good to fly it with the FPV on it, and give it a good workout and get some good video footage, hopefully. Right, here we go. Weight test. And when I say weight test, I don't mean mine. It just really felt heavy, that H-copter, so I dug out the old battery, which I used to use on it, which is this fella here, and it is weighing in at 410 nion grams. The one I had been upgraded to, which I just flew it with, is a 4-cell, and there you go, it is over 100 grams more than what I'd been flying it on previously, or previous versions of my H-copter, which is interesting. It, I mean, it doesn't sound much, 100 grams, but it certainly felt like a lot of weight there. I do, however, have a backup plan. I have managed to find a 4-cell, 4000 milliamp, and that is still coming in at 450 grams, so that's like it's still 60 grams lighter, which has to be a good thing. I've also got somewhere around here, there we go, I've also got a 4,500 milliamp 4-cell, and that's coming in at 450 as well, so those two. Other way to go. That one looks really puffed up. That I think that's when I crashed a Discovery on. Used to have a pair of those, but no longer, fortunately. So I think I'm gonna go and try it with a one of these on. Charge one of them up.